We all want to live in a world without crime. Well, maybe except for criminals. But should the government be trying to figure out if we are going to commit a crime in advance? It may sound like a situation from Minority Report, but the truth is that pre-crime technologies are being aggressively developed. One of the most notable current programs is known as FAST, Future Attribute Screening Technology. This pre-crime system is already so advanced that developers claim that it has an 80% success rate. FAST is a program created by the Department of Homeland Security. It was originally titled Project Hostile Intent. The purpose is to detect malintent by screening people for psychological and physiological indicators in a mobile screening laboratory. Under FAST, biometric-based psychological and behavioral cues are captured through several types of biometric data, such as body and eye movement, eye blink rate, body heat changes, and breathing patterns. FAST could be used wherever there are special security concerns, including stadiums, federal buildings, mass transit centers, and airports. The technology behind FAST is extremely complex, but it can be fooled. So once it's operational, you better not get too nervous or have a particularly bad day, because projected consequences of FAST can range from none to being temporarily detained to deportation, prison, or death. But this is not the only pre-crime technology we'll probably see in the future. A new brain study takes it a step further and may help law enforcement make an educated guess about which criminals will break the law again. Various psychological and biological factors are already used to judge whether an arrested individual is granted bail or the nature of their sentence if convicted. Age and sex are taken into account, as are behavioral qualities such as impulsivity and drug use. At the moment, however, these character traits are assessed by personality tests. Neuroscientists have long suspected that measuring the brain signal associated with these traits would increase the test's reliability. To test this theory, researchers studied a group of 96 male prisoners in New Mexico just before their release. Using fMRI, the team scanned the prisoners' brains while they completed a computer task measuring impulsivity. Researchers were particularly interested in a region of the brain called the anterior cingulate cortex, ACC, which is known to be linked to behavioral regulation and self-control. The researchers then followed the ex-convicts for 4 years to see how they fared. Among the subjects of the study, men who had lower ACC activity during the quick decision tasks were more likely to be arrested again after getting out of prison, even after the researchers accounted for other risk factors such as age, drug and alcohol abuse, and psychopathic traits. Men who were in the lower half of the ACC activity ranking had a 2.6-fold higher rate of rearrest for all crimes and a 4.3-fold higher rate of nonviolent crimes. If low activity in the anterior cingulate does in fact turn out to be a reliable predictor of recidivism, perhaps therapies that boost activity in this region would improve impulse control and prevent future crimes. But the researchers themselves stress that much more work is needed to prove that the technique is reliable and consistent, and that is likely to flag only the truly high-risk felons and leave the low-risk ones alone. There is growing interest in using technology to predict specific behavior, and studies such as this one, which tie brain imaging to concrete clinical outcomes, provide a new way to find patterns of brain activity that have broader implications for society. And what do you think of these new technologies? Leave a comment below with your opinion. Thanks for watching, and subscribe for more videos.